Hello students, welcome. So today we are going to discuss about group 17 elements. So in this group we have fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine and tennessine. So these are collectively known as halogens. In Greek, halo means salt and gene means bond, that is salt producer. So halogens are highly reactive non-metallic elements. They are usually electronegative. Like group 1 and 2, elements of group 17 shows great similarity amongst themselves. That much similarity is not found in the elements of other groups of periodic table. Also, there is a regular gradation in their physical and chemical properties. Astatine and tennessine are radioactive elements, so again, for these type of elements, we do not have much data available. So mainly, we are going to concentrate on fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. So fluorine and chlorine are fairly abundant while bromine and iodine is less. Fluorine is present mainly as insoluble fluorides and small quantities are present in soil, river, water plants and bones and teeth of animals. Seawater contains chlorides, bromides and iodides of sodium, potassium and magnesium and calcium. But it is mainly sodium chloride solution, 2.5% by mass. So it is the main source of NaCl. We know that we obtain NaCl from seawater. The deposit of dried up sea contains these compounds. Example, sodium chloride and carnallite. Certain form of marine life contains iodine in their system. And various seaweeds, for example, contains 0.5% of iodine and child sulfate contains 0.2 of sodium iodide. Here, important atomic and physical properties of group 17 elements other than tennessine are given along with the electronic configuration. Now, tennessine is lab synthesized element, that means it do not occur naturally. So just like the previous group, we do not have much data available because we can produce it for a very fraction of a second and instantly it will radiate energy and it will decompose in some simpler atoms. So that's why we do not have sufficient time to study tennessine. On other hand, last element, astatine, is naturally occurring element, but it is radioactive, so we have limited data about it. Now, some details of tennessine is mentioned here. So it is synthetic radioactive element, that means it do not occur naturally. Its symbol is TS, atomic number 117, atomic mass 294, and electronic configuration Rn 514 6d10 7s2 7p5. So common electronic configuration of this group will be ns2 np5. Only very small amount of the element could be prepared. Also, its half-life is in milliseconds only, and that is why its chemistry is could not be established. Atomic and physical properties of halogens are mentioned in this table. We have two separate categories. First, we have atomic state and then we have elemental state, that means molecules of these atoms. So as mentioned, atomic number and atomic masses are mentioned. Electronic configuration, common electronic configuration will be ns2 np5, and their covalent radiuses are mentioned. Now as we can see, each covalent radiuses are increasing, so it simply represents with increasing atomic number, orbitals also increases, and that's why size of atoms increases. So it shows regularity. For last element, we do not have much data available. Then we have ionic radiuses, and again same type of result will be obtained. Ionic radiuses gradually increases because all of the elements shows -1 oxidation state in their ionic state. So that's why they show regularity or increment. And a similar type of trend will be observed in ionization enthalpy as well, because they show almost same type of behavior as we discussed earlier. Electron gain enthalpy shows slightly different type of scenario. As we can see here, all the electron gain enthalpies are negative because electron gain enthalpies are always negative, because electron gain is an exothermic reaction. Whereas ionization, that means removal of electron, is endothermic, so it will be always positive. So as we can see, fluorine, although it is highest electronegative element, it releases less amount of energy as compared to chlorine. and later we show a regularity. That means, as we can see, we have comparatively lower released value from fluorine. Then in chlorine it increases and then it gradually decreases over iodine. So why this type of variation is observed? Reason is because of very small size of fluorine, electron-electron repulsion is quite high. So addition of electron becomes difficult. In case of chlorine, because of larger size, electrons are comparatively away from each other and that's why they produce less repulsion towards the incoming electron. So because of less repulsion, addition of electron in chlorine is comparatively easier than the fluorine. And that's why chlorine has comparatively more exothermic reaction than the fluorine. And later elements shows regularity. Then we have electronegativities. So all of these elements are highly electronegative. That's why they have comparatively quite high electronegativities. Then we have hydrogen enthalpy. Then that means when we dissolve it in water, what it gives. So these are the energies absorbed by this element during the hydration. So as mentioned, it is positive, so it is endothermic reaction. Now in second part, melting, boiling points, densities, distance and bond dissociation enthalpy along with electron potentials are mentioned. So all of these elements usually are in gaseous state in their normal temperature. So that's why their melting points and boiling points will be comparatively low. So melting points, as mentioned, we have increment in their melting points as well as in boiling point as we move from top to bottom. So iodine can be obtained in form of gas as well as in form of solid cubes at normal temperature because it has comparatively very quite high melting and boiling points. Other elements are usually in liquid element state or in gaseous state. Bromine, as we can see, it is liquid, while F2 and Cl2 are pure gases. Density, as we can see, it is increasing with increasing atomic numbers. Then we have X bond X distance, that means nuclear distance between two elements in these diatomic molecules. So again, if sizes are increasing, then distances also increases. And then we have bond dissociation. So again, some different type of situation is observing here. If this element shows regularity, then bond dissociation enthalpy should be like this. With moving towards the top to bottom, bond dissociation enthalpy should decrease. Because in case of fluorine, we have comparatively shorter bonds than chlorine. Chlorine has shorter bond than bromine and bromine has shorter bond than iodine. So that means longer bond represents weak bond, shorter bond represents stronger bonds. So it should show regularity in their bond dissociation enthalpy as well. But instead, its dissociation enthalpy is something like this. For fluorine, it is comparatively low. Then as we move towards the chlorine, it increases. And then as we move from bromine to iodine, again it decreases. So why? So same reason. Because of very small size in fluorine, electron-electron repulsions are quite high. And because of this repulsion, it becomes comparatively unstable than the chlorine. So according to stability order, chlorine is more stable than fluorine. It should be opposite, but because of small size and high electron repulsion, energy of fluorine increases. And that's why this type of irregularity occurs. And when these gases converts into the ions, at that reaction, they will release some electricity and values are mentioned. For fluorine, as we can see, value is highest and as we move from top to bottom, values decreases. So most of the points are already discussed in the tables, but some of the extra points are mentioned in this description as well. In case of atomic and ionic radii, these elements are present at almost last stage. So they have smallest atomic radii in their periods. That means fluorine will be smallest atom in its period or second period. And similarly, chlorine will be smallest in their third period. Because as we know, as we move from left to right, with increasing atomic number, atomic sizes reduces because central attraction or nuclear attraction becomes more and more dominant. So that's why sizes shrinks. Then Electron gain enthalpies. So all of these halogen elements are one electron less, or they have only one electron short from noble gas-like configuration, and that's why they gain electrons very strongly. That means their electron gain enthalpies will be comparatively very high if we compare it with other elements. And why fluorine shows irregularity? Reason is mentioned because of smaller size, it has very small 2p orbit, and because of that electron-electron repulsion increases and electron addition becomes difficult. Now let's talk about the physical properties. Halogen display smooth variation in their physical properties. Fluorine and chlorine are gases, bromine is liquid and iodine is solid. Their melting points and boiling points steadily increases with atomic number. This is due to the adsorption of radiation in visible region, which results in excitation of outer electrons to higher energy levels. By absorbing different quanta of radiation, they display different colors. For example, F2 has yellow, Cl2 is greenish yellow, Br2 red and I2 violet color. Fluorine-chlorine reacts with water, bromine and iodine are only sparingly soluble in water, but are soluble in various organic solvents such as chloroform, carbon tetrachloride, carbon disulfide and hydrocarbons to give colored solution. One curious anomaly we notice from table 7.8 is molar enthalpy of dissociation of F2 compared to Cl2. But we already discussed it. Whereas X mod X dissociation enthalpies from the chlorine onwards shows expected trend. So chlorine is higher than bromine and bromine is higher than iodine. So according to this common trend, fluorine should be more than chlorine, but instead it is less than chlorine. Reason for this anomaly is relatively large electron-electron repulsion along the lone pair of F2 molecules, where they are much closer to each other than the in case of chlorine. So because of comparatively closer distances or shorter distances, electrons repulse each other strongly. And because of this type of repulsion, stability of fluorine decreases, and that's why it requires less amount of energy than chlorine for dissociation. From next lecture, we will discuss about chemical properties of these elements.